Hello viewers, in today's session we will be covering a filter to the workspace. Basically, and what is the filter? It filters as per basically whatever the users end users are working on and specific data, so that filter can be applied. So basically it is useful to focus the task being worked on in a workspace to a data set. For example, we can implement a resort group filter which we will be following, but before that I would add on one more thing is we have missed a customer account and customer name in our workspace. That is the basic form, basically, not workspace. If you open the workspace now and you are going to open the booking order, so the customer account and name was missing here, which we did not basically dropped it on the form. And to simply drop it on form, I have just done one thing which you can also do. That is, you can go to the table. That table is basically booking table. And in the booking table, if you have noticed last time, we were working on overview as well as on details. So if you can directly add these two field, customer account and customer name, and drag and drop on these field groups, both of these, so basically on the form level these already are used. I will show you. If you see this details tab, details, this is basically a group, and that group is extending or using the data group details. That is a field group on the table level. So that then you need to just restore it by right clicking on the form and restore. So it will just add the more fields which we have now included. So that will be done. And if you are missing also customer account name on the grid level, that you can also drag and drop here. So that is basically not drag and drop, but this grid is also using the data group overview. So after restoring, automatically it will bring these two fields. So this was the missing part which I have added. So I thought that I would explain it before starting our this video. So just please complete this if you have not done it before. And now in order to add the filter, what we can do is we will just open our workspace form. That is this resort workspace. Okay, and on the design level you can right click here and just add a new group. Okay, and we can name it as for example workspace page filter group. Okay, and we can move it to the top by using alt and up arrow key. Up arrow and down arrow using alt key will move it above. So once the group is at the above level, the filter group is basically, then also you can see the pattern is unselected so far. You can right click and apply a pattern which is called workspace page filter group. So I will just apply this pattern and it will show me the input filter or field type is missing here. So we can add here a string control. Just right click and go to the string control. Okay, and you can name it just like resort group filter. Okay, and we need to change this EDT to the resort group EDT. So if you can check it, there is a resort group EDT. So this need to be, you can also drag and drop this EDT directly over here and it will create the control itself. For example, if I, no, it is not working. So I just can use this and here I can select this EDT. PKR resort group ID. So this EDT is now selected, and also we want auto declaration for this to be yes. Auto declaration to turn it to yes is when you want to refer this in code. So with the name of a control, you can refer in the code. So that's why we make this auto declaration as yes. So then what we can do is we can just expand the methods here, and this method we on the form level we need to expand this method instead of a control level method, and we can double click this class declaration, which will open the class here, resort workspace, which extends the form run. So now we need to tell the form engine basically that this workspace now implements basically an interface which is called sysiFilterProvider interface. So we need to change the declaration a bit. So we need to just after extend form run, we need to put here implements keyword, and then we need to use the interface which we'll be using, which is sysiFilterProvider interface. Now what we can do is we need to also declare a change event handler on the form level that will be used by the form engine. So we need to add a global variable. So that global variable need to be sysFilterChangeEvent, and give it a name like changeEvent. Next, we need to also initialize this variable. So and also we want to add we want to restore the last use value by the user on the workspace level. For that we need to implement the init method, and for that just go ahead and override init method and just remove the documentation. If you complete it, that's better, but for the sake of simplicity I'm removing it. So first line need to be sysFilter last value helper, and this there is a static method called get last value, and there I can use the controls name, and control name is resort group filter. So now resort group filter I am using here control name after auto declaring, otherwise it will not it will show the error. So since I have turned auto declaration yes, so I can use it. So I will use get last value and pass the control name. So then it is also good to introduce the documentation, whatever each line is doing. But for now, I will first complete this. Change event variable. To the change event variable, sysFilter change event. Then static method is new. From form control, and there also the same control name I can use here. So now what the each line does, I will just put a simple documentation that this will do a restore the last used value by the user, restores. And then this one initializes the variable, the change event variable basically. So this is the init method how we have implemented, which initialize whenever the form is open or the workspace is open. And then I need to also implement the close method. So it will be a close method. I will override whenever the workspace is closed, so it will save the value whatever was used. If we don't save, how we can use it? So in using the same helper class, I will use save last value and resort group filter. So I can also add a command or documentation that saves the used filter value for the next form launch. Okay, and just save it. And also, okay, now it's giving me error that a param filter method need to be implemented. So automatically it asks whatever the methods are being which are necessary. So just I will implement the method. Just let me check it. So I need to just implement it. It is not available to override. Basically, I need to implement new method basically, and that will be public sys I filter. This will be return type, and then param filter will be the method name. So this param filter method, basically this is a getter and setter, and what I can do is I just need to implement a filter variable, sys filter factory, create empty filter. So basically the param filter method is used to tell the form engine what to filter. Basically for that we need to implement this param filter method, and just follow me as I am doing. Filter value resolution method should be equals to sys filter value resolution method enum, that need to be all, and semicolon to terminate the statement. I will just adjust the windows on the right side. So after this, and then we need to initialize our table here. The table was resort group, PKR resort group table. So PKR resort group table, resort group, and then I need to just call the find method, resort group find method, to pass the controls value. For that what I can do is the name of control is basically resort group filter dot text will have the string value, and it will pass to this method find, which will return the table buffer. So after this, this I filter value need to be equals to sys filter value factory, create filter value for string, and we can use here resort group buffer, and what was our basically resort group ID was our field here, so that need to be passed. Okay, and then we can pass extended type num, that will be for EDT, that is PKR resort group ID, and finish the statement here, just save it. Okay, and then now we need to check whether if the resort group contains a record. So for that, rec ID should be zero, more than greater than zero. Okay, and then what we can do is filter value resolution method, that need to be pass here like sys assigned here filter value resolution method should be sys filter value resolution method. Okay, 1 minute. There is a typo here, so that need to be none. Okay, and then we need to add here filter dot add item, pass the filter value, comma, and sys filter operator equals filter value resolution method return filter. Just save it. Just build it. Okay, there is one more error, that param change event is also need to be implemented, and that we can just also implement. It is public sys filter change event return type and param change event. Return change event. Instead of checking the caller every time through switch statement, so implementing this interface is a better way to behave in order to behave the workspace as per called filter. So now we can see in front that there is a filter available which is a resort group, and it is showing like coastal. Once I select coastal and then downtown, you can see economy resorts is basically filtering, but there is no effect on booking order section here, booking orders and any other thing. Basically there is no other all resources implementing all, so it is only affecting the tile, but it is not affecting the booking order for that. And also it is also informative to be shared here, that basically the form engine automatically tests if the form implements the sysi filter provider interface. Then basically it uses the param filter which we have implemented here. Param filter is used, this method is used to know what it has to filter basically. So it does this based upon the metadata and relies also on the fact that EDT is used in the call to create filter value to a string. Create filter value to a string, the EDT is being used. So that EDT already contains, the lookup already is, form engine knows how to build a lookup, which is as you can see here. So this is basically determined by the EDT itself. Once we see the EDT, the resort group, if you remember that we have implemented here the table references, so that is already there, and there is nothing else. So this EDT basically EDT reference table is being used to build the auto lookup field group on the table. So I think you have already checked and seen that how it was implemented, the resort group lookup and the filter basically. And that's it for now, and let's tune in for the future videos. I'm targeting also for services or integration part, and definitely that I will also try to cover, and hopefully in the coming sessions.